you ever wondered how 3D models of people are made? Let's find out today. Let's meet Paweł, the founder of Humano.
We are a 3D people company and scanning studio. We create digital humans for architectural visualizations. I've started company in 2019 while still working as ArcVis artist and architect. From the same beginning, our goal is to create natural looking and affordable 3D people, so other artists can populate digital worlds in easy and realistic way.
Generally, we have two types of 3D models, post and animated. Let's learn a bit about both.
Scanning post models is similar to taking a photo. Our model has to stay still in the final pose for a second, while our cameras do their job. Scanning of models with intent to use for animation is a little bit different. Models need to stand in an A pose, with hands raised on the sides around 45 degrees. Later, we add a digital skeleton with digital bones for all parts of the body. This part is called rigging. For those scans, it's even more important to look at how clothes are looking, just to make sure that the model will look and feel natural when finished and animated.
Quick break. I'm just in the process of editing this video. It's crazy to see yourself as a 3D model. I'm super excited and happy to share with you that you can buy my models. Link will be in the corner and in the description below this video. Cannot wait to see myself in your visualizations. I will show you how to use them later on, but now let's go back to the video. We have been preparing for this scanning session way in advance. Before it began, we settled on topics and styles and defined the poses. We chose the outfit, some accessories and props that enhance the theme of the photo session. In my case, it was also necessary to schedule a hairdresser and makeup artist. The Humano team brought a nice atmosphere during the session, I felt relaxed and enjoyed the whole process. During the entire session, they need to make sure that their models look good. They gave me suggestions on poses and overall expression. It was kind of similar to a standard photo session.
Okay, let's learn how the process looks in practice.
For scanning, we use a process called photogrammetry. We take 250 photos taken all around the model in a fraction of a second.
Humano's scanner is made with custom-built construction. It consists of around 120 cameras and 4 wide-angle projectors. It's based on Raspberry Pi computers. Scanning went super smooth. For a single scan, 2 photos were taken in a split second. One photo is taken with structural light projection. It's a geometric pattern kind of similar to a QR code. It makes it easier for photogrammetry software to recreate the shape of scanned objects with much more precision and more details. The other photo is taken with natural light to be used for textures. All of this needs to be precisely timed and synchronized while a model needs to stand still for a second. It was kind of unnatural for me, especially when it came to facial expressions or walking poses, but it wasn't too hard. To truly illuminate object's color, the scanner uses special LED light with a high color rendering index. It's very important that the object is lit evenly from all sides, so textures do not include any shadow information. By using this scanner with LED light, the finished 3D model will look natural in scenes with various lighting scenarios. There are some limitations to that technology. It's harder to scan loose hair or dark and glossy surfaces. That's why we had to plan the outfit beforehand, and in my case, it was important to schedule a hairdresser and make my hair as tight as possible. A couple of my models have dark jackets though, but it was simply modified after the scanning based on this green one. The raw scan has around 20 to 30 million vertices. It's not perfect and needs a lot of processing. Raw scans are automatically processed multiple times to around 1 million vertices and pre-smoothed before the actual mesh cleaning process begins. As photogrammetry has its limitations, the scans need to be cleaned and refined. During the cleanup, RTS needs to get rid of artifacts, smooth uneven surfaces, and refine details in the most important and tricky areas. After the cleanup, the post models are further reduced and optimized for easy and fast use in any 3D software. Also, the texture of a scan needs some cleanup. After that, they also create different color variations, roughness, specular and normal maps. That ensures all details captured by the scanner are transferred to the final, optimized model. For rigged models, the process is even more complicated. First, the mesh needs to be retopologized. The model surface needs to be converted into quads, with loops placed in important places, so the animated mesh is deformed correctly and without issues. After that, they begin rigging. They add bones to create an armature for the model. Then, the skeleton is being connected to the mesh with a process called skinning. At this stage, weight paints for each bone need to be checked and adjusted to guarantee that the mesh is bound correctly to the skeleton. This is a crucial step to make sure that the mesh is moving correctly and realistically with the skeleton. The process is usually semi-automatic, but needs manual refining, corrections, and careful checking. This whole complicated process results in a model that can be set in almost any pose or be animated. You can even define where the model is looking. On top of that, they add special shapes to models' faces in all of their rigged models. Those shapes are called morphers, blend shapes, or shape keys, depending on the software. Each of those shapes refers to actual human microexpression. By combining them with different values and combinations, we can set almost any facial expression. The 52 shapes are made according to Apple AR Kit standards, so we can easily animate models with an iPhone. After that, they test the finished models with a series of poses and animations. In the end, they convert the models to the most popular software, render the previews, and upload the models to the website. That's basically how the human models are made. It sounds crazy complicated, and I am super grateful there are people out there who are willing to create them, so I can just drag and drop them into my renders and don't worry about anything. To use my post models, just choose the variation you like and drag and drop it into your scene. No extra work is required, just position it in the right place and hit render. If you haven't watched it yet, check out my stable diffusion tutorial. By using it, you can make your 3D people look super real. No need to spend a ton of time placing 2D people in Photoshop. Same with the rigged people. Here you can either use it in your visualizations by manually adjusting a pose, or use it in your animations by uploading a BIP or a CAD file, or manually animating the model.
Are you working on some new products right now?
Yeah, we are always trying to bring some innovation to 3D people world. Just recently, we've introduced models that feature 3D hair. These are called Rigged Plus models. 3D hair bring realism to the other level, as they look much more natural in different lighting scenarios. This has been the most requested feature among our users since the start of Humano. We create our hair models referencing to the scans and hairstyles of actual people. They are created with hair cards technique, so although the realistic look, the models are pretty lightweight as their geometry is very optimized. To make them and make them look believable requires countless hours of work and high level of skills. Rigged Plus models with facial expressions and 3D hair are great when you want to make high-quality animation or just to have a realistic person pose just as you need for your visualization.
You told me about a new exciting project you work on, Humano 2D. Can you tell us a bit more about this?
Yeah, recently we've launched a new service called Humano 2D. It is dedicated for users who prefer populating visualizations in Photoshop. It's the largest library of 2D people on the market and is based on our scans. You can just choose a matching person or a group in any light or any perspective and drag and drop them into the image, already with realistic shadows included. It's very easy and simple to use, perfect for any user.
You'll find the links to Humano 3D and 2D websites in the description. Huge thank you to Pavel and Ula for this amazing experience. Here you can buy my 3D models and here are two videos you can watch next. Purchasing my products is the best way to support my channel, which allows me to create better videos for you guys. If you use my models in your work, please share the results with me. Bye bye!